Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making strawberry pretzel salad. I have a recipe of my own, but I was sent a recipe by Luann Benge, and I thought, well, I'll just use hers because they're similar, and I'm sure it's similar to yours or one that you might have eaten. She says in her message, "This recipe did not originate with me. It has been around for some time. However, I have tweaked it a little over the years to make it my own. It's called strawberry pretzel salad, and it is just wonderful if you like sweet and salty things together." And then she's got the recipe typed out for me. So I'm going to follow her recipe, and I'm sure it's going to come out wonderful. We want to start out with pretzels. And since you're going to crush them, it would be nice to have the smaller ones. It doesn't really matter. You're going to crush them. But get the salted kind so you'll have that salty part to the recipe when you're looking for the sweet, salty flavor. You use 2 cups and you crush them. So I just put them in a Ziploc bag and used a rolling pin to go over them enough until they're fine enough to make a little crust in the bottom of a baking dish. So put this in a mixing bowl. And then Luann said that we could use 4 to 5 tablespoons of white sugar. And I'm going to take the smaller of those and use 4 tablespoons of sugar. Then add 3/4 cup melted butter. That would be 1 1/2 sticks of butter. Now we're going to mix this together. When you have your pretzels and sugar and butter mixed together, then put it in a 13 by 9 by 2 inch baking dish that has been sprayed with cooking oil spray. So I'm putting it in here, and then I will try to spread it evenly before it goes to the oven. Now that our crust is evened out, this goes to a 350 degree oven and we'll bake it for 9 to 10 minutes, or I'll be checking on it, and if I feel like it needs to come out earlier, I'll get it out. Here's our pretzel crust. It came from the oven and I left it in there for 8 minutes. It probably could have gone 9 or 10, but I felt like it was solid enough that it would serve as a crust, and I didn't want to overdo it. I certainly didn't want to burn it. So this is cooling on a cooling rack, and as it cools, I can go ahead and mix up the next portion of the recipe. We have 1 cup of white sugar that I'm putting into a large mixing bowl. I'm adding 2 8-ounce blocks of cream cheese. Actually, this is Neufchâtel cheese. I'm going to use an electric mixer. I'll start out on low speed, but go to medium speed and get these blended. By the way, the Neufchâtel cheese was at room temperature, and then I did microwave it a little bit to continue the softening. It needs to be soft when you do this. After using the mixer to blend our cream cheese and sugar, I'm going to just a large spoon, and I'm going to fold in 12 ounces of Cool Whip. I covered my cream cheese mixture with plastic wrap while I was waiting for the pretzel crust to cool completely. Now it's cool, and I have my fluffy cream cheese and whipped cream mixture, and I'm going to spread that out over the top. I'm just finishing up with the spreading of the whipped cream and cream cheese mixture over the top. That looks good. So I'm going to take this to the refrigerator and let it chill while I'm working on the next layer. This is a strawberry layer, and it starts with strawberry Jell-O. If you get the sugared kind, get the 6-ounce box. It will be the large box. That's what is written in the recipe. I'm just trying to cut a few calories here and there, so I'm using the large box of sugar-free. Put that into 2 cups of boiling water. This just came out of the microwave when it was boiling intensely. Stir those together and let's go on to our next part. We have frozen strawberries that have been thawed. This is a 16-ounce package. You can find those in the frozen food section, and you probably want to put it in the refrigerator overnight and let it get thawed. And I think what I'm going to do with this is let it cool down. Here we have our strawberry jello. After I've cooled it in the refrigerator, it's still very liquid, but it is cool. So I feel comfortable pouring it over the strawberries that are thawed and the juice that has come out of them. What I plan to do at this point varies a little bit from Luann's version, but I think it'll be fine. After stirring this, what I plan to do is place this back in the refrigerator and I'll watch it. Every 15 minutes or so, I'll check to see if it's beginning to gel. When it has that partially gelled look, then I'm going to pour it over the top of our layers that we have. We have these ready to go, but I don't want to pour pure liquid over the top. Our strawberry and jello mixture is thickening up, so what we're going to do is place it over the top of our layers. Just spread it out, and we'll try to make it even over the top. We're going to put some plastic wrap on top of it, take it to the refrigerator, and then let it sit for a couple of hours or up to overnight. Here is our finished strawberry pretzel salad. This is a single piece of it, and I'm going to take my taste from here. I want you to see the crust at the bottom. That pretzel crust holds together really well, and I know it has that salty flavor, which contrasts with the sweet flavor that we'll have in these layers above. So let's get a bite from the corner here and see what it tastes like. Really good. I don't think this would be anywhere near as good, nearly as good, if it weren't having the pretzel base, but it just makes it perfect to have that amount of salt mixing with the sweet. This is just a wonderful tasting recipe. I really like it a lot. Luann, thank you for sending it. I really appreciate your effort and your thought, and it's something that I had been meaning to make and just hadn't done, and I'm glad I made it and tried it out for you today.